Alright, so I'm actually gonna do a last reaction for I was gonna do a last reaction video for today, and that is 5 ways to cope with depression. And once again, it's by Blue Lifeline. Blue Lifeline. And every single day I feel with depression. I pretend to be happy every single day just to, how I'm gonna get away from all this foolishness and how I'm gonna, get out of this world just in case. But let's check it out in 3, 2, 1, go.
Anxiety can be a really crippling
Oh.
thing to deal with, but depression just beats me down to the floor. Like, it makes me not leave my room for weeks at a time. I'll just lay there, not doing anything, not caring about anything, just laying there, looking at my phone and just wasting my time doing absolutely nothing with myself. And I can't describe the feeling of
True.
just doing that. It just feels so sad, and I don't know, it just makes me feel a little worthless. Like, what am I doing with my life? Why am I like this? What's wrong with me? Why can't I function like other people can? I also know that not everyone can afford professional help, so I'm hoping that I myself can try to give you a little bit of guidance from my own experience with depression itself. Hello, my semi-dead audience, looking for some sort of hope or happiness in what seems like the most depressing time of your lives. Welcome back to a space online that is meant to give you some sort of relief or comfort, along with a reason to just laugh at all the horrible things in life that you simply cannot change. Depression amongst all age groups is at an all-time high, and I am here to give you some sort of relief from your suicidal thoughts, depressive mindset, and traumatic experiences that continue to replay in the back of your head. Self-harm is often glorified and seen as the best coping mechanism for depression, and that couldn't be farther from the truth. It's actually really unhealthy and terrible in general. Please don't do that. I know that many of you watching are probably really struggling with depression and how to cope with it, but I'm here to save the day, I hope, to give you a couple methods to maybe ease it, because they kind of helped me and I'm hoping they'll work for you too. Coping mechanism number one, socializing. I know that many of you with depression usually self-isolate and don't really go out or talk to anyone, stay in your room, and it can be really like hard just being alone constantly with your thoughts. So I think a way to get out of that is, even if you don't have a lot of friends or family, maybe just talking to someone or hanging out with someone, getting outside, doing something that you enjoy could really help with, like all the bad things in your head, and maybe distract you from them and make you feel a little happy and hopeful for your life. Coping mechanism number two, staying active. A lot of you tend to stay in your bed and not really want to do anything, and that can be really damaging to not only like your mental stability but your body. It can really hurt to lay in bed for so long. From my own experience, I've done that multiple times for weeks at a time, and it's not fun. I really hate it, and it makes me feel awful. A couple things that I like to do personally is exercise in my room if I don't feel like talking to anyone that day. Just exercise. It makes you feel energized and kind of nice about yourself and your body if you're insecure about that like me. You don't have to do that though. You can just go outside in the morning when no one's around and just take a stroll, walk outside, look at nature, enjoy some things, fresh air, things like that. Coping mechanism number three, eating healthy. I know many of you stray away from eating like healthy things, or you know, abusing substances like alcohol or just other drugs in general, and that's probably one of the worst things you could do for yourself, as it could really make you spiral into very depressive states of mind. And I think that eating healthy will literally make your body feel better, energized, and just healthy, nicer. So maybe things just like vegetables or water, drinking more water, staying hydrated can really like uplift you and make you feel nicer about yourself. Coping mechanism number 4, setting a routine for yourself. If you have a routine, it helps you plan things in terms of going to sleep at a certain time, planning a hobby at a certain time, eating at certain times. Without these, you know, routines, you would just be laying in bed and letting depression eat away at your day. And it's not a great feeling to just feel like you're sitting there doing nothing with yourself. So I think making a routine for your life would be very helpful for you. Coping mechanism number 5, facing your fears. I know this is easier said than done, but honestly, it really can help you. For an example, me sitting here, my back hurts a lot. I am very insecure about my looks, and my foot's asleep right now. So I'm kind of in pain, but it's all right because I am facing my fears. I am doing something that I normally would not do. Here I am, and I think you guys should try doing stuff like this too. Something you normally wouldn't think of yourself doing. New hobbies, meeting new people, doing new things, trying new food, something. Facing your fears. That is what this is. Remember, don't let depression keep you from living. Go out there and just infect people with your twisted, weird little happy souls. Well, that's pretty much it. Thank you all for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and even subscribe. We truly love all of you and hope you got a couple helpful coping mechanisms from this video. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
I mean, that's why I've been doing this whole day. I do every martial arts practice every single day, except Saturday and Sundays. Because every weekdays I do martial arts practice, and I'm trying to get better and better, but I don't know if I'm still ready. Because I'm worried that, I know a lot of people are going to be rejecting me, because I feel like whatever I'm still the worst type of martial art person, just in case, and, yeah, I drink water every single day just in case I won't even mess up my throat, just in case something bad would happen. And I eat fruit every single time I use it, just in case. I'm still trying to go outside. So, I don't know if my mom even let me every single time, because, she never takes me outside. She never helps me get a job. She never helps me, help me get a hobby. I mean, she never did anything to me, just in case. And, I'm trying my best here to, a lot of noises that y'all hear, It stressed me out and it gets me a lot of depression every single time I hear it. You know, a lot of noises. Like, I'm still trying to, like, you know, I'm just wanting to find my own ways of trying to find a house, and perhaps I could do my own ways just without the noises and stuff, just in case. Well, without the noises and yelling and stuff, just in case it would get back to normal, 'cause I just wanna be all by myself, that's all. If not, then I probably as well kill myself anyway, so yeah. But let me know, comment down below, what is your copious ways of depressing? And I think that's gonna be it. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe if you're new here. Click the bell notification down below just in case y'all miss